Warning.
Oh!
Oh, I'm feeling it. I'm feeling this shit.
Next time, it's gonna be glass.
Feel that. I could go kung fu right now. I could go for a good kung fu movie. After the after part, I'm gonna watch some old school kung fu, man. Some Enter the Dragon. I'm gonna get that going here, man. Anyway, Pepe, without further ado, you know what to do. It is time for the Inside Star Citizen review. It's time. Let's do it. Welcome to the Inside Star Citizen Review, and welcome to DG360. Yeah, Dutch, bring it. Thank you. Screaming Cowboy DG in the house. Thank you so much, Dutch, for those generous biddies that you've offered up for us so that we can shove right back to you guys. Tonight, Inside Star Citizen Review. Thursday is my favorite day. If you're watching this on YouTube, I'm sorry you can't be here live with the fam feeling this first level energy. If you're watching it on YouTube, you better smash the like button right now and break that algorithm and do what you need to do as part of a member of this army. You grow it. Now, tonight, 8 minutes and 17 seconds. Now, we already know I got some against this. We already know going into this, like, I get real feisty when it does not hit my sweet spot. With the time on this is not 11 to 15 minutes, and it isn't in my sweet spot, you get a salty DG. Salt up in the stash. Salt up in the stash. So this better be good, because I will rail against this. And this is a follow-through from last week's, which I was super excited about. Last week's and the weeks before, the last two have been like, boom, hit me so nice. So this one, I hope, is going to do the same thing. I want that follow through. I want to see what happens to goods and inventory after serious decisions are made from mechanics of Death of the Spaceman that we watched on the last episode. Without further ado, let's watch. Let's see what happens to the inventory items. Let's see what's going on here. Let's see if they keep it hardcore. Let's do this.
Me again. It's time for part two of Alpha 315 Changes Everything. This week, the team is back to talk inventory and finally put all those globals and locals and vehicles and externals and personals into context with one another as they set the table for a truly physicalized universe coming down the line.
Truly physicalized.
Producing like the next bit.
Truly physicalized inventories that affect the economy, that they will continually persist. Physicalized inventories, physicalized items that are directly connected to an economy that are persistent. That is the combination we are looking for here.
Big step towards Death of a Spaceman. Now we're introducing the first huge leap towards the physicalized inventory. This is really the biggest milestone for inventory in general. The move towards physicalized inventory is really an attempt to make players think and make choices.
This is the loop where you have to decide what I take with me is the stuff that I have access to me.
And those choices should be reflecting players' gameplay choices, their styles. The restrictive manner will mean that, you know, you get emergent roles in the groups, people bringing all the heat with them because the other guys around them have all the ammo, that kind of thing. So that there are so many different aspects involved in
loving
restricting
it.
Things that encourage communication and, you know, cooperation, that yes. change the way that you play the game and yes. ultimately drastically impact the experience.
So if you've played Star Citizen, and I hope you have, then you'll be familiar with the global inventory. You're able to access anything you want at any location.
You could be carrying, you know, a whale in your backpack, and we don't want that.
That is being nuked with prejudice. So from now on, you won't have access to the PMA. You will still have access to the VMA for all of your ships and your ship items and equipment, but anything related to your character will be in the local inventory. Local inventory is the largest space that you have access to. It's not infinite, but it will be the largest space that you have access to. And that is tied to what you'd imagine the location that you're in.
So let's take, for example,
Paul. All right, let's not make it too easy, though. Let's just not make it too easy here. I mean, like, a local inventory that's tied to what? Everything around me, containers, every, like, I get it. You got, like, a little hot window where you can grab and stash and boop, 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 with all the cargo that's around you. But let's not go too crazy with this. Yeah, I'm not quite sure I like this, actually. But let's go. Let's keep watching.
Alistar, whilst I'm on the station, I can access Port Alistar.
All right, all right. Stored within the Ash list. Is saying this is just an intermediate solution until physical inventory is in. Okay, Ash, okay.
Location inventory. As soon as I leave the station and fly off, I can no longer access those items.
So when you open up your inventory, you'll be able to just press I or go through it, the person in a thought, and open up your inventory, and you'll see, okay, there's all of the gear on my character, and then you'll have another kind of window on the other side, which will show all of your local inventory.
That's going to make you consider, what am I going to take with me from this location? It's also introduced...
I'm going to tell you the good and the bad about this, right? Because in battle situations, you're going to have these items that are going to be tied to different squads. And you're not going to be able to get into the opposing squads, but there's going to be have to be code that differentiates their local loot from your own local loot. From what I'm gathering, this is like your own personal inventory, your own loot in the locale, in the area. Now, whether this is going to encompass like the squad that you're in and the team that you're in and their inventory, that's another question. That's not being answered here. I don't think so. But that's going to involve, it can get a little bit messy. Okay. And this is okay. Great. Ash. Thank you so much. Ash is filling me in on stuff that probably I haven't even heard yet. He says this is only available at stations and landing zones. Okay. Much better. Feel better about that. Do they mention anything about inside your ships? Do they mention anything about your ship that you're in? Because that would be interesting to me. Dutch says they need to look at Tarkov and use that as a model. I love Tarkov's inventory and UI. I do. I absolutely love the way they stack it. Tarkov's awesome. Okay, they do? They do. Okay, great. Thank you.
Do you see the concept of, I want certain things in these locations, so I now have to move them there. I have to physically go there to put them in those locations. Another key aspect of local inventory, which you now set the very first time that you sign in, is your home location.
That home residence has two purposes. One, it becomes your regeneration point, your default regeneration point, whether the hospital or the nearest hospital nearby. And the other thing is that it becomes your default home location for all of your gear, equipment, subscriber flares, vehicles, everything that you own will be deposited at this location.
So we've touched on the largest scale inventory that we have, the location inventory. The next one down is a vehicle inventory. And that marries an inventory container with a ship interior. In the same way that you have to be a location in order to access your location inventory, you have to be inside your ship to access your vehicle inventory.
Now, one question that really needs to be answered here, is this also going to be everybody else that is involved with you, that's in a squad with you, that's in the ship with you? Will they also have access to the same thing that could be troublesome, could be worrisome? But it's not yet. Okay, so this is specifically your own goods, your own loot in vicinities and cannot be seen by other players. So that's something that should be, and I hope it doesn't lock you out from grabbing those things from containers as well. And I don't think it would. Yeah, this is really interesting how they're going to code this. Like, I'm thinking about this from a developer's point of view and how they're going to code it. This is just like a UI kind of code, all that I'm seeing here. I don't think it's specific to locking down goods when you're playing in game. The ship may be public. Right, Soriel. You know, one of the reasons I'm asking, right, is I just want to know a little bit more about the functionality of it. Like, Soriel from Mongrel says, we hope we have access to your ship's storage when we board you. One of the reasons I want to kind of nail this down is because I can see a lot of negative to this. You know, as far as like being, you know, logistics wise and ease of use, and, you know, this is kind of like a very easy thing. And I understand that for today's, you know, gamer, like people want just like quick, instant, you know, gratification and shit. But it could also be bad in terms of like security issues as well. So, you know, we are, yeah, like Star says, Tafari says, we're all going to find out together pretty much. Orison says, I think for now it's only available to you if it's your ship. Mm-hmm. Bad Ash says, yeah, I don't think they said anything about other players accessing the ship inventory. It's, you know, this is something on Spectrum that we really should follow up on. We should ask a lot of these types of questions if they're not answered here. So let's just keep watching.
Larger ships will have more inventory and smaller ships will have less inventory. And this is simulating all of the lockers and all the physical storage that you would have had on those ships.
The interface allows you to drag and drop from location to vehicle, so you'll be able to move items between locations. The next inventory scale down is external inventory, and that's any inventory container that you're trapped with that's basically in a box.
Yeah, the tabs are pretty
nice. It can be in a ship, or it can be a crate out in the world, or it can be a loot box. It can be anything.
Okay, that is a little bit more concerning to me. When he said it could be, you guys hear what he said right there? Hold on a second.
A box.
It can be on a ship, or it can be a crate out in the world, or it can be a loot box. It can be anything.
All right, now we're getting into like a security issue. Now we're like ease of use and access, right? And the UI, and boom, 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 and over. Security. So like security needs to kind of, yeah, I'm curious. I'm going to have to play this. I'm going to have to play this and experiment with this. I know Sorio is as well.
It could even be the corpses that you leave.
The hell?
When you kill someone, the amount of flesh and bones that they leave behind is something you can try.
All right, now this is another thing that I'm worried about. Say you're, okay, corpses that you take down, is this specific to your kills? If not, and somebody's in this locale with you walking around and you take this guy down and he's got like some epic, epic gear, somebody just like wants to check out the UI, see what's going on, shove, 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 shove. Like you're doing all the work, blah, 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 blah. You're doing all the work, right? And then some dude's got the UI open and he's like, oh, I like that gun. I like this gun. I like that gun. I like this gun. I like that gun. I'll take that. I'll take that. In the meantime, you're like, okay, sweet, sweet. Now let me see what I got. And then you open up the window and there's nothing there. Oh, boy. I'm not quite sure I'm into this.
Around inside. It's an interface that allows you to drag off
like the utility.
All the weapons, etc.
I'm just worried. Like, here's the thing I would say. I love the utility. I'm just not quite sure I'm cool with the security. I'm cool with the utility of this and the functionality. I'm not quite sure how security fits into this. You know, it's the very opposite of Care Bear, actually, because basically what I'm saying here, Vorpal, is if I'm doing all the killing, give me that fucking loot and you better take your hands off of it. It's actually the very opposite of being a Care Bear. I don't know why you would say that I would be a Care Bear for saying that, if that's what you're referring to. Security is Pepe, the guy who hide all your kills. Now, if we can lock shit down and we can keep shit separated, okay. But like now we're talking about like one giant large orgy pile where everybody can kind of like grab and pull and take whatever they want. And I'm not quite sure I'm okay with that. You know, I'm not quite sure. This makes things very, very messy, very chaotic, which, you know, I do love the chaos. But if I'm doing a lot of the work and then, you know, by the time I'm done with my work and I'm focused on, you know, imagine Erad, like we got Erad in here. Imagine Eradicator's in here. He's like, you've been eradicated. You've been eradicated. He's doing all this work. He's like, he's just like blowing people up left and right. Heads are popping, you know, boomstick going off. And he's like, okay, now I will see what I've got in here. And they're like, there's nothing. It's like a ghost town, like a little bush like flies past. Could you imagine how upset he would be? I would be a little upset. Access to friends' backpacks live. We've already warned we will put live grenades in each other's packs. Yeah, they're going to have a coding nightmare. They're going to have a coding nightmare with this. I'm not quite sure how they're separating this or how they're doing this, but I definitely want more information with this. Definitely going to need more information with this.
So finally, the smallest form of inventory is personal inventory. And that's anything that has an inventory container attached to it that you can wear. So whether that's trousers and jacket, there'll be a corresponding UI container for your jacket pockets, for your trouser pockets, etc. That's environment suits, that's core armor, that's leg armor.
And backpacks.
And Startafari says it's just like looting weapons off NPC now, just loot everything. The one thing that I really... The one old school reason I really liked Star Citizen was everything was very tactile. Everything was like feel and touch and realism. And like you had to go and pick these things up and put them down and persistence and, you know, all this thing. And I understand the utility of this, but I'm not quite sure. I think we're moving away from that by doing this. And I'm just confused right now. I'm kind of processing the information right now. And I'm kind of sitting on the fence right here. So far, I'm a little bit more negative towards this than positive.
Now it's separated from cores. So you can choose which armor
it's a first
you prefer
draft, for
based
real.
On the choices that you want. And then you'll be able to associate a different backpack to the armor. Light goes with light. Medium can have medium and light. And heavy can have heavy, medium, and light.
So with all these different types
I don't know if that's true. Tripal's saying you actually have to take the items directly off the body, DG, not just be close to it. Now, that's what I'm talking about. So if that's the case, then okay. But like from what I saw, it looked like he said to me about a minute or and a half ago is that you kill the guy and it also shows up. He's like, you can loot from the screen, not directly from grabbing off the body. At least that's what I thought I heard. So am I wrong on that? I'm not quite sure, because I'm not quite sure. Sir's getting mad at me. He's like, you're making mountains out of molehills. I don't know, dude. I think it affects gameplay quite a bit. That's me, you know. That's my opinion. I'm allowed to have those, sir. Sometimes I'm not going to like it. I'm not going to like every episode, buddy. You know, like, you know what I mean? The video showed taking the item from the body. Yeah, the video did, but I thought the guy said in the panel. Here, let's go back here. Hold on a second. Hold on. Where was that at exactly? Where he talked about taking it from the body here. Maybe I'm wrong. Let's go back. 340. Way forward later on, you guys are saying? I don't know. I'm right around 340. Here, hold on one second. 440 even. Okay, that's better. All right, I was not too bad there. Let's see.
It could be anything.
Items between locations. The next inventory scale down is external inventory, and that's any inventory container that you interact with that's basically in a box.
It can be on a ship, or it can be a crate out in the world, or it can be a loot box. It can be anything.
I mean, I would have to imagine that they're item specific to the actual player. Like, I couldn't imagine your ship sitting out there and then just going right up to it and being like, oh, hey, cool. I'm going to take the shit off the ship. That'll make Soriel's job a lot easier as a pirate.
It could even be the corpses that you leave.
It could even be the corpses that you leave.
The hell?
When you kill someone, the amount of flesh and bones that they leave behind is something you can interact with and start rummaging around inside. It's an interface that allows you to drag off armor, weapons, etc. So finally, the smallest form of inventory is...
So did that mean that you have to grab it off the dude? Is that what we're saying by watching that? Because I'm not quite sure if that's what that meant. Yeah. Okay. All right. All right.
Is personal
I feel better.
Anything that has an inventory container.
Do we want to see that in slow-mo? Apparently, I did say we were going to do one slow-mo every episode here. I think this deserves a slow-mo right here. Slow-mo time. Let's do it down. We're going to slow-mo it down. As you should. For those of you not familiar, this is our slow-mo segment.
When you kill someone.
When you kill someone.
them out of flesh and bones that leave behind is something you can track with and start rummaging around inside.
All right, there we go. Slow-mo of the week. There we go. This is slow-mo. Remind me, every week now, that's part of the Inside Star Citizen review. That's part of the Inside Star Citizen
review. This place allows you to drag off armor, slow-mo weapons, etc. So finally, the smallest form of inventory is personal inventory. And that's anything that has an inventory container attached to it that you can wear. So whether that's trousers and jacket, there'll be a corresponding UI container for your jacket pockets, for your trouser pockets, etc. That's environment suits, that's core armor,
leg armor.
And backpacks now are separated from cores. So you can choose which armor you prefer based on the choices that you want. And then you'll be able to associate a different backpack to the armor. Light goes with light, medium can have medium and light, and heavy can have heavy, medium, and light.
So with all these different types of inventories, different sizes and whatnot, that brings us to asking, how do you track where everything is? How do I know where I've left that bag of ammo? That brings us to Knickknacks, which is a new mobile app that we're introducing alongside inventory.
You're able to load up Knickknacks, look at it, and at any moment get a real-time update of all of the items that you have. So you want to know where that P6LR is. You're like, oh, where did I leave it? Oh, I left it on my ship that's in Port Olisar. Oh, cool. I can go and get that.
As with many other features that have been released with Star Citizen, there's more to come. We'll continue to improve it and work on it and flesh out additional functionality. There's a lot more things to consider, to remember, and to coordinate over. I think we're moving towards what the game is intending to be.
It's very easy as game designers or game developers to focus on individual mechanics and say, oh, this mechanic does this and this mechanic does this. But what my job is and what I'm trying to help deliver and, you know, is to deliver Chris Roberts' vision. And that vision is this Star Citizen experience that everybody loves and wants to play and everybody is working towards. And inventory and healing are huge ways of moving towards that goal. And the biggest thing that you'll notice is that they're going to change how you play the game.
Right. So what did we learn this week? There's an enormous shift coming to the way everything from shopping to trading to vehicle spawning is happening in the persistent universe. That inventory management will become a more tactical endeavor when the answer to what's in the cave becomes
more tactical, less tactile. So that's actually what I'm getting from this. I hope I like it. I'm going to try it out. Obviously it's going to be the first iteration. I'm not going to be harsh on it. I'm just going to see what it's about. You know, like how many times have we gone through flight designs, you know, like how many times have we done different types of flight mechanics that we've tested and gone through? It's the same thing with most of these iterations. So this is going to be like iteration one, baby iteration, and then it'll improve as we go, as more input and more people play it. And that, you know, so overall, if as long as security stays intact, I'm cool. As long as security in a way stays intact and security is still like up there and an important factor in design of this UI and utility kind of upgrade, for the lack of a better word right now, then I'm okay with this. But I'm gonna have to play with it a lot just to make sure that I'm okay with it. I think there's gonna be a lot of kind of, you know, on the surface it looks great, but it could be something that could cause a lot of headaches. So I'm really interested in this. I'm very interested in this. Thank you. Hey, welcome. Welcome, Juice. Welcome to the fam.
Only what you take with you. And that when combined with last week's injury and healing changes, 315 is shaping up to be quite a patch. Now, don't forget, Ship Showdown is now in the Elite 8. And since I recorded this a few weeks ago, I'm going to go ahead and assume the Argo Cargo is running away with the entire thing. And remember, Digital Citizen Con is coming October 9th, so keep an eye out for even more details in the coming weeks.
For Inside Taking the Star day with Citizen, you guys. We're going to stream all day.
We'll see
That's
you all
That's going to be fun.
Week.
All right, everyone. If you are watching this on YouTube, you know, we're sorry you cannot join the party here. We are going to be having an after party of very epic proportions live. So make sure you get here live next time. But don't forget, we are having an $8.90 jump giveaway. Thank you, SPCF, for donating that to this community. We love you, bro. He is awesome for doing this. And don't forget to smash that like button if you're watching on YouTube. Break that algorithm. If you like the show, if you've been here live, being part of this, obviously you want this to grow. Do it. Do what you can. Buy YouTube and hello After Party. Let us have some fun now. It's After Party time, Pepe. Let's switch it on over to After Party Mode.